Welcome to Naresai Technologies. This is Ramchandar. In this video, I'm going to develop one small program which is useful for reading the data from the file as well as writing the data into file itself. So already we've seen this type of example in previous videos, but in that particular time I'm using the byte streams classes. But especially in this video, I'm taking the support of character streams. There are two basic classes under the character streams for writing as well as reading. For writing purpose, there is one basic class, that is file writer. Another one is file reader. File writer and file reader. So first let me develop somewhat programs on top of the file writer. Later we'll see about file reader concept. Now observe here cleanly. File writer is introduced in the version of 1.1. It is introduced in the version of 1.1. Now internally for file creation purpose, file writer is taking the support of file output stream, and file output stream is taking the support of file class to creating file. If the file is existed, that file will be using by the file writer class. If not existed, file writer will take the support of file output stream, and file output stream will take the support of file class to create a new file. So let me show you all this information through programmatically. Now I'm taking one class here. That class name is FW demo, file writer demo. Now in the file writer demo, I'm taking one main method. Yes, here I'm taking main method. First let me take one file. File f equal to new file. Here I'm taking like one file name test.txt. Now this file class is suitable to make a communication with that particular file like test.txt. Now by using this stream, I want to write something into that file. How? By using file writer class. File writer fw equal to new file writer. File writer fw equal to new file writer of f. New file writer of f. File writer is throwing one exception. What is that? IO exception. What is that? IO exception. Yeah. Now if you observe clearly, we have around 5 constructors. File writer of file. File writer of file descriptor and a string, and another one is file class object and boolean argument, and file writer and boolean argument. So let me show you, let me use all the constructors for writing the data into the file. Now observe here, file writer, in this particular time I'm taking the support of first constructor, that is what your file writer of file argument. File writer of file argument. Now if you're using file output stream, we have a 3 methods for writing the data. Those are write of byte array, write of int, and the one is write of some fixed size, like a 3 argument we have, some specific length also we can give. But here we have a 5 methods. FW dot write. If you clearly observe, there are 5 methods: string, char array with some size, and int, string with some size. Now let me take a file writer. Here I am writing like, first let me take a char array. Let me take a char array here. Let me take char array. Char array c equal to new char. Otherwise, let me take n I t. There are some three characters that I am placed into variable c. Now, here I'm writing C here. Now I'm writing like system.out.println. System.out.println. Data stored in the file. Good. If you are executing this program, Java application, then it will showing like a data stored in the file. But the problem here is, if you are working with the files in the Eclipse, by default the file is not visible. Just refresh it. Yes, file is visible right now. Test.txt, there is no data like NIT. By default, these classes are unable to place the data into file, this class, especially file writer. We need to use one more method, flush. Give pressure on top of this class. Which class? File writer class. Once we using the flush method, automatically the content will go and stored in the place. Now see the content. What is that? NIT. So if you work with the file output stream, no need to write flush method. Directly the data will be stored in the file. But if you work with the file writer, definitely we should write one method. What is that method? A flush method. Yes. Now, if you cleanly observe, if you open the file writer source code, so by the way, I didn't add source code related to file writer, then how to add the source code? Very simple. Just move the cursor on top of the file writer and click on and press control and move the cursor. Automatically it will asking like a file open declaration. In the background, if you have code, that code will be visible. But I didn't add any code to file writer. So click on attach source. Now it is asking second option, external location, external file. Where exactly we stored? So Java, under the Java JDK, there is one file, src file, source code is available. Click on open and click on OK. Now file writer information is available. So now let me open this file writer. File writer internally it will taking the support of what? File writer internally see file writer of F I mention. F is what here? It's a file object. It is a file object. That file object will go and place it into where here? One parameter like a file. Again the same parameter we are hand over to whom here? File output stream. Let me open file output stream. So file output stream constructor. So whatever the file I'm giving, that file first go and place it into the file writer constructor. From the file writer constructor, the control go and place it into where here? That file name will go and place it into file output stream constructor. Again, from the file output stream constructor, this method means same class constructor will be, same class one more constructor is calling. See, this is what here, file output stream, G single argument. Now control goes to where here, file output stream, double argument. Okay, now automatically, what happened? Here automatically, it will take the support of a file class. It will take the support of file class and finally it will creating one particular file. That file name is what here? Test.txt. One more time I am repeating. I am open the file writer predefined code which is given by the Java. File writer constructor will calling new output stream class constructor. And a file output stream, this is single argument constructor will calling same class double argument constructor. So here we have some code which is useful for getting the path. And based on the path, it is going to check whether the file is existed or not. If the file is existed, not a problem. If the file is not existed, internally it will creating what here? File itself. and this constructor internally will take the support of what your file descriptor also. Okay, now so if you are already, I told you, if you are working with the file writer means indirectly it is called what your file output stream, and it will work with the file as well as a file descriptor also internally working. Now this is the way we can place the data into the file. Now it is not only providing one method, it will providing what your three methods. Now here I'm writing like a 32. Why I'm taking here especially 32? The reason is 32 will provide the space. After that, file write off. Now here I'm writing like, here I'm writing like Karthik. Here I'm writing like what here? Karthik IT. So first I'm writing individually characters NIT. Later I'm sending the data like what here? Karthik IT. Now file writer dot write off. Again I'm writing like 32. File write off 32. After that, I'm taking one more char array I'm taking. Here I'm writing like very simple. Here I'm writing like A, B, C, D, E I'm taking, F I'm taking. So here I'm taking 6 characters, but I don't want to place all the 6 characters. I want to place only 3 characters like CDE into the file. Then what we need to do? A very simple guys. Nothing is there. A damn easy thing. That is fw dot write off C1. From which character I want to place into the file here? C. 0, 1, 2. Now, how many characters I want to place? 3 characters. See. If I'm executing this program, if I observe this code, first NIT placed, later 32 placed, later Karthik IT placed, again later 32 placed, nothing but space will provide, later C, D, E will available, NIT space, Karthik IT space, and C, D, E. Now, I want to place some length of a string. For example, let me take internationalization. Now here 5, 11, nothing but I'm placing here data from 5, 11. What I'm getting, see, instead of writing 11, let me do this 5, 6. Here I'm writing like fw dot write of 32. Now see the beauty. Now you can see the some particular content. What is that content? Nation. So from 5th position, I'm placing how many characters? 6 characters. 6 characters from the 5th position. 5th position means what here? N, A, T, I, O, N. 6 characters. So like this, we can use these 5 methods for inserting the data into your file. Char array with some specific length, string with a specific length, and finally int type of data. So here I'm using file writer, file argument. Now I'm taking true here. If I'm taking true here, what happened? Observe here, and better to add 32 one more time. More clarity. If I'm executing this program, what happened? Observe. If you're using only file writer of file object, if keep on executing the program, every time old data will be replaced with the new data. But if you want to hold old data as well as new data, definitely we should prefer two argument constructor. One is file object and the one is what your boolean. If you're writing true, then what happened? Very simple. Old data will be available as well as new data available. NIT, Karthik IT, CDE, Nation. Nation, after that what here? NIT, Karthik IT, CDE, Nation. So if you observe this one, like one more time, 32 is not updated. Yeah. 3 times. Naresh IT, Nation, NIT, Karthik IT, CDE, again. NIT, Karthik IT, CD. So like this data is going to place into the various file. Now that means old data is available as well as new data. Instead of writing true, If I am writing like what here? False. Instead of writing true, if I am writing like false, this in this particular time, it is same as what here? It is same as single argument constructor. It is same as this constructor, same as what here? Single argument constructor. Nothing but old data will be replaced with new data. Old data will be replaced with what here? New data. Understand or not? So like this, we can able to work with what here? Files itself. We can write the data into the file. Now, if you cleanly observe, let me take one more constructor, Control C, Control V. Now here, instead of writing file object, I'm taking what here? One string, nothing but directly I'm giving what here? File name. So let me execute this one. If you are executing this one, if you observe the project, there is no test1.txt. Just refresh this one, refresh it. Test1.txt is coming. So Naresh IT, NIT, Karthik IT, CDE and Nation will be available. Now, it is also having file with Boolean we have. File with Boolean constructor or Boolean argument constructor. If I am writing like a true, already we learned. What happened? Old data is available as well as what here? New data is also available. Old data available as well as what here? New data is also available. Okay. If you're writing false, then what happened? If you're executing this program one time and see the code, then what happened? Old data will be replaced with new data. So like this, we can use multiple constructor for writing the data into various file itself. So this is entirely I covered. The main important point is, whenever we working with the file writer, internally we working with what here? File output stream, file, as well as what here? Descriptor also. So this is the program for writing the data into the file. I hope you enjoy this video. For more videos, please subscribe Naresh IT channel. Thank you.